Well, I guess you can guess by what we got going here that we're... that we are in the beginnings of this whole month, we're going to be talking about creation. And today we're starting with trees. And I have a story that sadly timely happened this week. Next to our house, it really was on our neighbor's property, but really was part of our property too, was an oak tree that was 200 years old that had to be cut down. For 3 years I've been saying to my neighbor, it's all right, it's going to come back. It's going to be okay. They wanted to cut it down, but there wasn't a leaf on the tree. But I kept hoping and hoping that it was going to come back. But he was very worried it was going to fall on our house, which is very nice. So they started to cut it down. It was very sad to watch. Think what was happening 200 years ago when that tree was there. Do you think there was any houses there?
No.
No houses. It was all, I live right by the Des Plaines River, so there probably was some Indians still left there, all around that tree. So it's sad to think that that tree had to go. But in my yard, growing by the side of my house, was a baby oak tree that started growing probably from that tree. And what's the seed? Who knows? What's the seed that makes an oak tree grow? What is it, Natalia? Yeah, you're right. It's an acorn, that's right. It's an acorn that makes trees. So it dropped there next to the side of my house, and that tree was starting to grow there. So right there I find creation amazing. As one thing died, another had started to grow. Now we knew the tree was about 200 years old because you know one way you can tell how old a tree is. How can you tell?
By the roots.
Partly by the roots, how big they are. What else?
If you cut it down, you might see the
tree. You can tell by the circles and try to decide the tree stuff. But if you have a tree in your yard and the tree is healthy and you're wondering how old that tree is. Do you know there's a formula to tell how old that tree is? There's been a growth thing that tells how fast a tree grows. For instance, a maple tree grows 4.5. That's their growth factor. So if you measure around the tree how wide the tree is, let's say we have a 10-inch trunk, and you divide it by chi, which one of you guys, what's chi? Who knows what's high? 3.54. That is correct. So if you take the diameter of the tree, divide it by pi, you get how old, and do it by the growth factor, you get how old the tree is. So if the tree was about 10 inches around and you divided that, and the growth factor is 4.5, you didn't know you were going to get master today, did you? The tree would be 45. So I want you all to go home and measure a tree in your yard and figure out how old it is. So, we have the sadness of that oak growing. And our story today is about Paul, who was a wonderful, wonderful teacher. And he traveled all around going to talk to people. But as he traveled, he saw a lot of different terrains and a lot of different areas and a lot of different growth. And at the beginning of our story, the part that Jeff didn't read yet, we know that Paul, as he traveled, also took in not only the people, but the creation around him. As he would walk through the forest, he would look at the trees and think about what they did as being shelter for people, being homes for animals, being trees that grew fruit or olives, that they could feed people, and the greenery and the beautiful smells and all of it around them. He thought about that and thought about what God has created. And when he was done doing that, then he went into the city and talked to the people. And yes, he thought what they had built was beautiful. The beautiful churches, because we have a beautiful church here. And the beautiful buildings and statues, but he said, that's not God. You are strong and mighty and have deep roots. Can you show me big, strong, and mighty? Put your arms up like big, strong, and mighty. Yes. Maybe you're a baby oak tree, so you're not as strong and mighty yet. You're like this oak tree here in the bucket, so you're not strong and mighty yet. Okay. Who would like to be a willow tree? Oh, dear. Who would like to be a willow tree? Okay, come on up. Okay, you are a willow tree. Have you ever seen a willow tree? What's neat about a willow tree is a willow tree, let's see, can bend and flow no matter what happens, can go all over. And now this one's going to be a maple tree. Oh, come on up. Calissa wants to be a maple tree. Okay. Calissa, you will be a maple tree. And at this time of year, maple trees, here, turn so everyone can see you. Maple trees have beautiful different colored leaves in the fall. They're starting to change colors. Have you noticed that? They're so pretty. I have in my neighbor's yard, they have beautiful red maple trees. And they have gorgeous leaves. All right, so we have some mighty trees here in our forest. And God has created a wonderful, wonderful place for us to live. Like John talked about, we need to take care of it. We need to be strong. We need to remember that this is God's creation and it's ours to take care of. And as Paul spread the message to all the people about God's love, he reminded them in our story today that God is really in creation. Let us pray. Dear God, you took away the mighty oak, but you gave us a new one. You bring to us all these wonderful growing youth and young adults that are putting their roots down. Help us to be those who water and nourish and care for them to grow in their love for